Hi students, welcome to video module 123. So in this module, further we are going to discuss compensation management objectives, components and types. So the learning objective of this module is to learn objectives of compensation and various components of compensation management and different types of the compensations that are existing in the organizational context. So these are the learnings you can say that you are going to gain out of this video module. So let us just see that objectives of compensation management. It is to attract the competent personnel, because when we have a good compensation management and good compensation for our employees, so generally people will be opting to join or to work with that company. So then to retain the present employees, so we can retain the present employees who are talented and then doing well for the company, and since the compensation is good and then it is as per their expectations and then meeting their requirements, they won't leave the company. So if the compensation is not up to their expectations, so the talented people, they won't stay with us and then they will leave the company. And the compensation is improving the productivity. So you can see that it improves the productivity, efficiency, and then it controls the cost also and ensures the fairness. So all these are the main objectives. You can see, once we have a good compensation, that encourages, motivates employees to do more work, that improves the productivity, and then it brings the efficiency also. So in the efficiency process, what happens, we will take less time and then we just use the less resources. And as a whole, you can see that the less cost, and then cost can be controlled because of a good compensation system in the company. And it ensures the fairness. So always you can see that the employees who are actually working with us, so they are getting the salary as per their the contribution and to the extent, so they are happy with the payment. So it improves the union management relations also, because most of the problems are between the management and union is related to the wages or the compensation. So that we can overcome, and then we can improve cordial relations. So it also improves the public image of the company, because if the company is paying good salaries and then compensation, so in the public, in the society, what happens, the company will have a very good status, right? And then as a whole, you can see that the company with the legal regulations, so you can get the very good reputation with the government bodies and even the public also. So these are the objectives of compensation management. So objectives of compensation management, you can see that it is related to adequate and then equitable incentive providing and cost effective, secure and balanced and acceptable to the employees. So these are all a compensation systems, a kind of the features, or even you can say that objectives. So it must be adequate, whatever that we are paying to the employees, and it must be equitable, and then incentive providing and cost effective, and secure, whatever that they are getting, and then balanced, and then acceptable to the all employees. So these are the main things. Then if you look at the essential compensations like internal equity, external the competitiveness, and the built-in incentives linked with the productivity and individual work and increments. So we have to look at all these essentials when we are preparing compensation for our employees. So if you see the types of components, the compensations, you can see that the various different types, like you can see mainly direct compensation, indirect compensation. So there are two categories. So under the indirect compensations, you will find that production programs are pay for the time not for work, and the service, and then you can see that prerequisites, these are all three important issues under indirect compensation. So production related, medical insurance and life insurance and disabilities and pension and then social security, all these are the various indirect benefits. So at the same time, pay for the time and not for work, like vacations and then holidays, sick leaves, and then other jury duties. There are many other the leaves for that the payment is made, right? The services and then prerequisites, like recreational the facilities and car, and then financial the planning and the low cost, and then free meal or even canteen facilities, and then providing sometimes the housing with cable TV or even internet. So all these are the indirect benefits. So then if you look at the direct the compensation, like the basic pay and the merit pay, and in the basic pay, like you can see the salary and then wages, and in the direct compensation you can see that incentive pay, and then you can see that deferred the pay. So incentive pay, like the bonus and then the commissions, and so you'll find that the piece rate system, then profit sharing, and the stock option schemes, and then shift allowances. So all these are the various issues. And the deferred pay is like in the saving plan, and then the stock the purchasing the scheme, and then so all these are the different the types of payments that you can see. So these payments are under two categories, so direct and indirect. And indirect is we get indirectly all these benefits, and direct benefits, that means we are getting monthly or even fortnight or weekly. So directly the cash is paid to the employees as per the legal provisions, right? So then components of remunerations, like you can see the financial and non-financial, like wage and salary, and then incentives, and then fringe benefits, and then prerequisites like company care, clubs, and all other things. All these are the financial benefits. And then non-financial benefits, like job content, like challenging job or responsibilities, supervision, growth for the prospects, and giving membership and working conditions, improving working conditions, providing services like a car and even other the benefits. So all these are the non-financial benefits. Okay. So if you look at the remuneration models, like a job description, job evaluation, job hierarchy, pay survey, the price jobs, and the pay level, and then pay grade. So you can see that the payment that we start, the remuneration calculation or determination starts with the job description, and we take the complete job evaluation, that is the worth of the job, and then job hierarchy, we will see that we conduct the pay surveys among other organizations and within our organization. And then we'll go for the pricing of the jobs, like a pay level and then pay grades that we fix. So these are all the models. So with this, let me stop here, and looking forward to meet you in the video 124. Thank you.